Hello, Aquarius. I hope you're doing awesome today. Thank you for being here. Let's get right into your reading. Aquarius, if you are here, which obviously you are, you're meant to be. So let's find out why, shall we? Aquarius, who am I connecting with today? Who is in your energy? What is happening? Let's find out. All right. First card. We have Mask. Okay, what else do we have? We have the Hermit, Virgo energy, and we have Romance. Alrighty, okay, Mask, the Hermit, Romance. And under here, we have the Six of Cups. What's under that? We have the Ten of Pentacles. Communication. The first thing that's coming to mind is communication. Possibly somebody like offering you some kind of commitment, you know, with that Ten of Pentacles. Because all I'm seeing on the Six of Cups is this woman on the card talking. And that's all I'm focused on whenever I look at that card. So I just feel like somebody's going to express something to you. With that Mask card, I feel like it's, you know, something that, I don't know how the hell that happened. So this Ace of Pentacles somehow flew out of the deck as I was holding it like this to sit it down. I don't know where the hell that came from. Some kind of weird magic trick. Okay. So we also have the Ace of Pentacles. I'll have to look at the video and see how the fuck that came out of the deck. I don't know. That was weird. I'm probably not going to be too impressed whenever I watch the video. It's going to be like, oh, okay, so it just fell out. Why am I freaking out? But anyway, so yeah, it looks like somebody wants to offer you something. Somebody wants to communicate their feelings, you know, something that they've kept hidden with this Mask and the Hermit. And I'm going to have to guess it has something to do with some kind of romance, some kind of relationship. So let's take a look. And look, I split the deck to shuffle and I split it at the Lovers, Gemini energy. So let's take a look. Who is this? What does Aquarius need to know about this situation? We have the Three of Wands. We have the Four of Pentacles. We have the Ace of Wands. And we have the Seven of Cups. On the bottom here, we have the Nine of Pentacles. And we have the Five of Swords. You know, this is their mask, I feel like, this Nine of Pentacles. They put on this mask of like, you know, I'm single, I'm ready to mingle. But deep down, they're connected to you. They want you. And it's almost like a defense mechanism or like, coping mechanism. I don't even know what to call it. Where they like to put on this facade that they're this kind of player, you know, they're flirty, you know, whatever. But deep down, I feel like they're actually like a hopeless romantic and they're not somebody who's like actually a player. Like they don't actually like sleep around, you know, that kind of stuff. But yeah, they put on this facade that they're single, they love being single, but they're actually, they wear their heart on their sleeve. And I think that's something that you wouldn't know, that you don't know about this person. But they keep it hidden because it's like they have to put on this mask to seem tough or to protect themselves or, you know, something along those lines. But this person, again, I feel like this might be like a hopeless romantic type energy. But they've been holding back, clearly. Again, with this Three of Wands, it's this feeling of like, even though their back might be turned, and then even on this Hermit card, this person's back is turned toward the camera, even though it's a drawing, but also on the Romance card, their backs are turned toward the camera. But even though their backs might be turned toward you, it's like you are where their heart is. You are what they want. And it's not necessarily that I think that they literally have turned their back on you. It's just that they keep themselves, their feelings for you, so hidden, or at least they have. I feel like that's about to change because, again, you know, the Six of Pentacles here, somebody's about to express their feelings. All right, somebody's about to say something that you don't know. Maybe you might know, maybe you've picked up on hints, but honestly, I feel like this might be a bit of a shock to somebody, or, you know, whoever's resonating. I don't think you expect it, because they put on such a front, like, oh, I'm single, I love flirting, I love being around, you know, people that I find attractive, or, you know, whatever. But they don't actually get with those people. They just, again, it's like this weird, like, mask that they put on to protect themselves. I don't know how else to explain it. So, okay, so Three of Wands, why is this here? Sorry if that was loud. We have the Four of Swords. We have the King of Pentacles, Earth sign energy. And we have the Nine of Pentacles again. And then we have the Queen of Swords here at the bottom, air sign energy. Again, they put on this facade of, like, you know, King of Pentacles. Like, they have a lot going on, that they have a lot going for them, which I feel like they do. I feel like this person is very attractive, that, you know, they have it easy when it comes to, like, you know, attracting people. And they might, you know, they feed into that. I'm not going to lie. They feed into the attention that they get. But deep down, it's like Four of Swords, not really interested in, like, the people that are around them. But they're interested in you. And I think that might be why, like, some of you here might feel like, oh, I don't have a chance with them. They have all these options. First of all, don't think that way about yourself. Of course you have a chance with them. Why wouldn't they want you? And second of all, they do want you, okay? And they don't actually feel a connection with these people, okay? Because whoever this is, whoever I'm connecting with today, they do seem to have options. Do they act out on those options? No. Because deep down, they are like a hopeless romantic. They are a very monogamous type of person. Even though on the surface, they may not look that way. Okay, so Four of Pentacles, why is this here? We have the Five of Wands. We have the Five of Cups. And we have Strength. Leo energy. Okay, so again, this is the obstacle, right? This is what's holding them back. Putting on this mask of strength that they're Mr. and Mrs. Tough Guy, Tough Girl, you know, whatever. You know, they have all these options. They're very whoever this is, they're very flirty. Like, they love flirting. But I feel like the way they flirt, it's not like, it's more so like a way that they give compliments to people. It doesn't really go any deeper than that. You know, for some of you, you may not realize that. You may think that there's kind of a player. But that's just kind of how they communicate with people. I don't know. It's so hard to describe, because it's like this person, even though they come across like the Four of Pentacles, like they're holding back, they have this side to them where they look like, you know, they're very open, outgoing. But there's this part of them that they keep hidden, that they don't show to people. And that's the part that they want to give to you. Okay. And, you know, that could also be their mask. Like, they wear this mask that they're this outgoing, you know, flirtatious type of person. But deep down, you know, that's just a mask. That's just how they portray themselves. But they want somebody where they can be, like, their real self. And show the romantic side, and show, like, and give their heart to, basically. So I feel like, you know, the flirtatious part of them, or, you know, whatever, I feel like that does kind of come from a place of insecurity, too, whoever this is, you know, whoever I'm connecting with here. Because they, it's weird, because it's like they like that attention, they like making people feel good, because they get something back from it. But at the same time, it's a mask. Am I making sense here? So this person kind of has this weird, like, contradictiveness to them, you know? So they might, like, you know, flirt around, or they might be outgoing, have a lot of friends, have a lot of people around them, have a lot of options or whatever. But deep down, they just want to stay at home and, like, you know, live like a hermit. Like, and, like, I don't know, cozy up with you on the couch or something like that. Okay, so Ace of Wands, why is this here? We have the Moon, Cancer, Pisces, we have the Four of Cups, and we have the Six of Swords. Again, a lot of, like, you know, this attraction, Ace of Wands, you light them up, possibly they light you up. But there's so much hidden here. There, even on this, you know, Six of Swords is in the dark. There's a moon here as well. There's a lot of, like, hidden emotion. And I feel like whoever I'm talking to today, I feel like this Four of Cups is representing your energy. You might be feeling a little down, like wondering, like, why don't they want me? You know, notice how her head is down. And then there's this person, I guess, yeah, his arm is like reaching through the window trying to offer her a cup, but she has no idea because she's like all sad and depressed, wishing for a cup. But she has no idea that there's one just right there. And that's kind of the energy that's here. It's like this person, they have this emotion for you. They really want you and they're about to say something. Again, I feel like some kind of communication's coming through, you know, with Ace of Pentacles, with that Six of Cups. But you, like, you have no idea that it's like right behind you, that this is like sneaking up on you, this communication. I mean, also with the Six of Swords, some kind of communication, you know, and it's gonna be, I wanna say, a bit of a shock, a bit of surprise with the Moon, the Six of Swords with the dark here. It's gonna like come out of the dark. I don't know what that means. I mean, even the Hermit here is in the dark. Maybe they're gonna text you at nighttime. Okay, so, Seven of Cups, why is this here? We have the Ten of Swords. We have the Ace of Swords. I was just thinking, you know, I said the Ace of Swords, right? Yeah. But the Ten of Swords, numerology, a ten goes back to a one. And then we have that one here, so it's an ending and a beginning. So an ending to the silence. And a beginning to some kind of communication. You know, the sword, communication. They choose you. Because I'm looking at the Seven of Cups, like all these options. You know, this person looks like they have options, but they choose you. And they're about to tell you. We have the Three of Cups. They choose you, the Fool, Aries energy. And we have the Ace of Wands. Again, yeah, like, you're the one that lights them up. It's like they could be in a crowded room, surrounded by people who want to talk to them, but it's like their eyes are just on you. Okay, that's the kind of energy I get off this person. They are very much like a hopeless romantic. It's like once you have their heart, it's like yours forever. Like that's the kind of person this is. Very, like, again, hopeless romantic. I don't know how else to say it. And they really want something with you. There is communication coming in about this, about them finally saying this, because I feel like, again, whoever I'm connecting with, you have been in this Four of Cups, like kind of down about this situation, just wishing that you could have them, wanting them. And feeling like, you know, possibly for some of you, feeling like you're not good enough. And again, look at the air quotes, not good enough. Of course you're good enough, okay? Stop with those thoughts. And obviously you're good enough because they want you. So, any details as to when or how this might happen? Obviously, I can't predict this exactly because this is a general reading, but... Okay, well, those wanted to fly out. We have the Tower, and we have the Three of Cups. And we have the Star, Aquarius energy. They choose you. And we have the Chariot here at the bottom, Cancer energy. So this could happen Cancer season. I mean, that's coming up pretty soon. Under that, we have the Knight of Swords, communication. So this is, you know, possibly sooner than you think, possibly around Cancer season. But it's like something, some kind of connection of theirs. I want to look into that a bit more. We have the Two of Pentacles. We have the Emperor, Aries energy. We have judgment. We have the world. Okay, so it's like something is changing in their life. I just heard near death experience. I don't know what the fuck that means. Hopefully they don't go through anything like that. But it's like something, it's like a huge like life, I don't want to say life-changing moment for them, because that just sounds like too dramatic and unrealistic, but I mean, maybe for somebody. But it's like they have some kind of weird epiphany about like the people in their life, somebody in their life, and it kind of just rewrites their reality, if that makes sense. Because, you know, maybe they're starting to become like fed up with, you know, kind of being phony in a way. You know, like I said, they, you know, maybe they flirt with a bunch of people, they have a bunch of people around, but that's not real to them. Again, deep down, this person is, they feel very deeply. They're a very passionate person. They're a hopeless romantic. But it's like something happens in their life where they have some kind of epiphany and they're like, you know what, I'm sick of this bullshit. I'm sick of, like, you know, having all these people around me, but not truly connecting with any of them. And I think, you know, whenever they have that moment, that leads them to you. They're like, you know what, I want Aquarius. Damn it. So, and then again, coming in soon, I want to say around Cancer season. So that's the best I can do with timeline. Obviously, lots of you might be watching, so I can't be exact, but... But yeah, that is your reading today, Aquarius. If that resonated, or if you just enjoyed the reading, leave some banana emojis in the comments below. Also, for any of you who care, I might not be able to post the next few days because I am going out of town. I'm going to be meeting up with a friend in West Virginia for a few days. So I don't know. I might be back Monday. I might post while I'm up there. I don't know. So if any of you are wondering, like, where the hell are you? That's where I am. So, but yeah, yeah, if you like the reading, like and subscribe, and I will talk to you soon. Bye.